Yo, what up? Shut up.
Yeah.
I want to collab with everybody's favorite. That's exactly what I want to do. Whoever your favorite is, let me know so I can work with them, because I want to be everybody's favorite too. I really take a lot of ideas. Like a lot of artists, I'm not gonna say artists. Some people feel like artists don't want to get like advice, I guess you could say. You know, inspiration comes from many different forms. I mean, I can sit outside and see something and be inspired by it. I like to hear people say, you know, you would sound ill with such and such, or I would love to hear a track from this person and that person, because it's like, you know, you're leaving a little piece of your history, honestly. I feel like my music is my legacy. I feel like, you know, journalists write it down. MCs, they speak it. You know, they're storytellers, and that's the most important thing. You can hear a song from years, like 300 years ago, and it's going to be a track. So it's like, when you think of who you want to work with, think about the message you're trying to put out there. Think about your longevity. Think about what little piece of you want to stay here when you're gone. That's really it. I mean, you know, shout out to Nina B, of course, out in New York, doing her thing. Much love, sis. But, you know, she always says, remember me, Nina B, and I think it's very important. How do you want to be remembered? That's really it. How do you want your legacy to read? How do you want your story to be read? That's what I'm all about. I'm writing a book. I just want everybody to read it. Take what you want from me. As far as collaborations go, I think that, you know, it's kind of funny, because I feel like some people are scared to do collaborations. Like, they feel that just because they're trying to get on, like, they have to be all by myself and that's it. I mean, it's good to establish yourself as an individual, but what's the point of doing it if you're not working with other people? I mean, you're never going to experience new things. I think collaborations is one of the greatest things in music. It's very important who you collab with. I mean, some people, they do the mistake of just collabing with everybody that wants to get on a song. You can't really do that. You know what I mean? It has to be some type of blend, some type of connection. I'm very much into knowing the people that I work with and getting to know some of the people that, you know, what type of style they have and how I can add to it and how they can add to whatever I have going on, and, you know, vice versa. I mean, I always say the phrase, Big Boy said, you know, Big Boy Outkast, he said, each one teach one. And that's very important. Like, you know, you might make a song with somebody that you never thought you'd make a song with in your life, and it's the best song you've ever had, and it opens your eyes to different types of things. Out there, what I want people to know about me is music is my passion, this is culture, it's what gave me, damn it, every single type of motivation and every single thing I've been in. Because I believe in music a lot, I believe in the power of voice, I believe in, you know, influence and change. You know, I'm lucky enough to be somebody who was put in a lot of great opportunities and great positions, and I was able to bring it back to my peers. You know what I mean? I was born in a little hut in Haiti, went to Mattapan, went to Milton, grew up there, you know, going to school there. But every day I'm in different places in Boston. I got chances to go away, do little academic things and just, you know, sports things. You know, my first show, shout out to Keith Whitlow. Honestly, Touch 106, I booked my first show off of a radio interview. I didn't have a mixtape out. I didn't have anything. All I had was the rhymes that I had in my book. And, you know, Keith Whitlow and DJ Clay, you know, they definitely held me down. Gave me a platform, got my first show out at Dublin House. Then went to Sammy's Patio, linked up with Famous Nobodies, and then went straight down to the University. Providence. I got a lot of love from Rhode Island. All my starting up shows, the colleges out there, crazy. Shout out to Rhode Island College. Shout out to Brown. Shout out to URI. A lot of fashion shows, they show me a lot of love. My boy, the whole team out there. But I mean, a lot of people really believe, I can say some people believed in me a little bit more than I believed in myself in the beginning. You know, I didn't really understand what I really had at the time. I just thought it was, you know, I'm a poet trying to cross over into hip hop. And I had all those people that I named, they really just told me that, you know, Ma, you already there. So, you know, if it wasn't for those people, honestly, I definitely wouldn't be where I'm at right now. So I'm gonna take y'all with me, most definitely. The whole family, my whole family, of course, you know, we will be. So. But yeah, you know, shout out to everybody that's doing something right now in Boston. They holla, Lady Meatball. Shout out to Chief. Shout out to Urban Nerds, of course, they're doing their thing. They holla. You know, I can go on forever, but, you know, y'all gonna be hearing about me. I'm gonna be in y'all mouths too. So. listen to the haters in my ribs. And I really feel like we need to motivate each other more and just see what we can really get out of everybody. I mean, there's a lot of passion inside people that is scared to let go. And my last name is ReBelle because, and it's R-E-B-E-L-L-E, because I think that rebellious people or revolutionary people get such like a bad name, when in all actuality, they have enough guts to be themselves. And that's all I plan on doing. So I'm going to take it to the top. So I'll meet you there. Yo, main thing with some of the artists out here, honestly, like, all happiness and motivation aside, would you educate yourselves, people, please? You don't have to go to I went to a four-year university, you know what I'm saying? And that's cool. That's what's up. That's my story. You know what I mean? You don't have to go to school to learn. You read some. Go on the internet. Learn how to do it. Shout out to Making It Mad, you know, out in Atlanta. Shout out to the Kevin Shine, the A&R, you know, he's great. And I follow his advice off of Twitter. You know what I mean? I've never met him. I speak to him, but I never met him. And I feel like a lot of people, they use the I don't know as an excuse. Learn it. Figure it out. That's what separates you from a lot of other people. It's not like you have to go to school to learn this. You just have to train yourself. If you want to rap, you should be writing every single day. If you want to learn how to be a songwriter, you should go and study records. Go to the Billboard. See what's on the top 10. See what's on the top 100. See why they're like that. Study the song. And now I realize, because I'm doing this for real and I'm doing this professionally, I'm realizing that was training I didn't even realize I was doing. Because if you go to any label, they're going to tell you right away, if your record does not catch somebody's attention in the first like 10 to 30 seconds, it's nothing. It's a wrap. It's not going anywhere. And that was how I tested it. If I didn't know the song, I'd have to know why. You know what I mean? And you got to really work for yours. I mean, this Ms. someone, Kevin Shine, shout out to you, of course. He told me, this business is made to break you. And it's real. This business is made to break you. So you have to have that mentality where you won't let it. It's not, he's not doing this for me and he didn't do this right and this person didn't handle this. It's not even all about that. It's about what are you going to do to make sure that the worst never happens. You got to be precautious. You got to be grounded. You know what I mean? You got to really learn a little bit of everything. That's the only way you can really do this. Everybody, you know, if you want to reach me, trust and believe, I'm all for collaborations. Reach out, I'll reach right back out to you. You can find me at www.ReBelleNation.com/DutchReBelle, Dutch R-E-B-E-L-L-E. Don't forget the bell because it's beautiful. You can find me on Twitter. Follow me on Twitter fam, Dutch ReBelle, FN, same spelling, of course. Anybody that want to reach out for any type of thing, it doesn't matter what it is. Every pedal has their purpose. Just holla at Bill. No time for anything else but Bill. And, it's me. Yeah. Dutch ReBelle here with Finished Magazine. All of those that aren't ready to really get down to work and handle business, it's finished. You gotta see me. Be out. Dutch. Now I put out a mini mixtape as a little introduction for people to know a little bit about what I'm about. But this next project, Beauty vs. the Beast, mixtape coming out hopefully in the winter time. That's definitely my baby. That's my real, introduction to who I am, what I'm about, what makes me who I am.